as much as we can, right?
Right.
Did you hear that question?
Yeah. Bumpers, fenders. Last video showed a huge collector car junkyard auction. Tons of parts, tons of cars. It was a 2-day sale. This video and the one after it will show the process of loading and some of the pieces that we bought from the scrap guys.
And a few of the vehicles they bought and loaded.
Fortunately, there was equipment around. However, the sheer volume of stuff and the cheap prices at the auction meant that we bought a lot, and being nearly 3 hours from home, we were about to embark on the logistical puzzle of getting home everything that we had bought within the short 2-week window of getting things out. So I'll start with a quick rundown of the cars we bought. I got this 68 Pontiac 2-door hardtop. Tempest, Le Mans, and GTO were offered in this body shell. Next video, I'll reveal what that one is. I did buy the 69 Thunderbird. I believe that's the right year for that one. There's a friend of mine who's into those cars. Some of you might know him here on YouTube. So that one will be headed off to his place after everything is loaded and task list kind of dies down. Joe bought the 1936 Chevrolet. This is a good parts car. It's got a lot of good pieces on it. Kind of rough, but these old wood-bodied GM cars are pretty hard to find anymore. He got the 56 Chevy 2-door post, 1967 LTD 2-door hardtop, 1946 to 48 Pontiac Torpedo, 1953, I believe, Ford station wagon, 1951 Ford Victoria 2-door hardtop, 1941 Ford coupe, 1940 Lincoln. I bought the 1961 Chevrolet Biscayne along with a 1963 Bel Air. Well, two actually. 1935 Chevrolet Master coupe body minus the doors. Many of the other cars sold to other collectors, and some to the salvage buyers. The auction went a little long the first day, but we had driven a long way to get there and brought a trailer, so dark or not, we were determined to get our loads made. The place was very full of vehicles, and it got even more full when the trucks and trailers came to load, so we just backed up to the easiest two that rolled, kind of a crime of opportunity, and pulled them on the trailer as quickly as we could.
As much as we can, right?
Right.
Did you hear that question?
Yeah. Bumpers, fenders. Late night loads. Joe's the designated guy to get his hands black on that steering wheel.
Can't tell, but that's supposed to be gray, not black.
When it comes this way, Joe.
Yep, yep. How am I on the other one?
What?
How am I on the other? Okay. Well, it's not staying right because this one actually is sliding on the ground. Hold it!
Now the logs are right there on the trailer, Joe.
I see that. Pop, get the two logs there. Go ahead. Once it gets up to the trailer underneath, we're going to have to put the logs in it.
Yeah, kind of protect those running boards.
With how bad that tire is, it rolls decently.
Yes! Okay. In.
Okay. I can't hear you.
In.
Go ahead.
Pop, get closer to him. You can hear.
Better be quick before the frame drops out of it. This old Ford's going to the scrapyard, unfortunately, so they don't really care how rough they are loading it.
That's good right there.
Get it there?
Yep. You want me to back under that if you get it up? Okay. Perry, you want to hop in there and back it up?
You watch that, didn't you?
Yeah. Come on back. Come on back. Good. That'll work. That's good.
The Pontiac was my first load out. I filled the car with parts. On the front of the trailer there, you can see there's a front clip for a 1935 Pontiac. Stay tuned. That goes with a vehicle that I've got a deal made on, so you'll definitely want to see that one coming up here soon. And then had that huge pile of bumpers, so filled up the center cavity with bumpers. It's a full moon that night, so I was able to unload relatively easily. Still a bit of a challenge without the front end rolling. I don't really particularly enjoy buying beached cars.
But you buy them how you find them, you take what's around, and then you do what you gotta do. If he gets it up, they can just back under it.
Can he come up and under it? Yeah. Come up over.
These ones are headed off to the Great Iron Yard in the sky. That's a true 65 Malibu SS, and then a 39 Oldsmobile that was burned and probably had a shed fall on it. All roads lead to the scrapyard. Look at you, the millwright. Sure you don't want to give up junking and be a millwright?
I was already a carpenter for many years.
Lincoln Zephyr Coupe. Gonna be at the Rust Ranch. The 1956 Chevy two-door post was the second car for that load. Then the Lincoln and the 56 headed to the Rust Ranch. Put it down and forward a little. There you go. All right. Level those forks out, and then that strap won't slide back. Yeah, pick it up and drop them down. There you go. I decided to save the 40 Plymouth Coupe body from the scrap guys. It is really rough, but it's a 40 Plymouth Coupe. They're not making them anymore. And even as rough as it is, I thought something like maybe a race car body or a rat rod, something like that. Someone probably would want this car to do something with. It was just too neat to see it get squashed, so I saved it. All that open space in the inside, perfect spot to fill up with bumpers. So I did, and kept chipping away at the bumper pile. More of them came home. There's Joe's next load, a couple 40s Studebaker pickups. Joe saved a two-door body of his own. This is like a 37, 38 Ford. Guess there's enough of a floor in there to hold it.
I'm sorting them right now. Huh? I'm sorting them right now. I'll have a good pile for you when I'm done.
Everything's restorable if you have enough money. You're done there, son. We went through most of that.
Bought this 1920s Dodge Brothers truck. Not quite sure of the year on this one. Really cool truck. Look forward to more of a walk around on it in my next video.
You're in your ramp.
Huh?
You're in your ramp. Get your... There you go. Steer it this way. That back wheel is coming into the side. There you go.
what the...
You want him to set that one ahead of the front fenders?
Okay, can you back up or will it tip the machine? I'm going to back up right here on this grass.
Now he tilted, he could come another.
Yeah, let me
six
let me
inches.
Back up just about this one corner. I kind of want to set.
I don't think I need the tires, though.
He could throw the tires in your bed if he had to.
I don't know, I had to.
We'll heap all that other stuff in there. That's probably good. I don't know how long your tie downs are.
Okay. And just push on it. Thank you, sir.
Those short forks probably work best for the X-frame. Catch it right in the middle. Level them out. Precarious, but it's working. It's gonna be close. It needs to steer over. There you go.
Easy way. Here we go. I had to film that with you hanging out.
All right. Thank you. It was $2,000. A guy would have had to bid 25 to buy it.
Well, I'd have been here, I'd have bid it.
Yep.
I didn't. Oh, no, you should have bought it.
If you got a chain, you got a chain. Don't worry about it.
You could have bought it and sold it.
We need a chain.
Huh?
We need a chain.
I know, that's what I'm asking. If you had a chain.
Tom, if you know. If you know any folk songs about railroading, now would be a good time to sing one. If you know any folk songs about railroading, now would be a good time to sing one. Because it's a train.
Well, they had the Amazon or in Monroe, Virginia. It's you're away behind time. This is not 38. This is on 97. So, shovel on a little more coal. For when we cross that wide old mountain, they gonna watch on 97. He was coming down the creek, making 90 miles an hour. Well, broke into a stream. They found a new river. They named it the throttle. It's called the Tidal Mountain Speed. Well, all you ladies better take warning. From this time on and learn. Never speak harsh words to your true husband. He may leave you and never
hear. Yep. Yeah. Huh. We're looking for replacement parts. Like one of these old Model T door hinges, you just rivet that in there.
What is it?
I don't know. It's a reinforcement for something. Oh.
The one is artillery of some kind.
Oh, yeah.
I
Probably could have left the flats on, I guess.
What about that spare tire? You want to pull it off now?
Hey, Gordy, go get my jack. And the rattle gun.
We need another ratchet for the door from the hood?
Two of them.
Boy, this is a cool car.
Coach Arn, are we not going anymore?
We should have put these ramps
over. Oh, we got plenty of room. I think we'll have plenty of room.
Okay. Look, cash in your pocket. That should have covered what you spent, right?
Yep.
That should make the wife happy.
Yep.
Now just don't go blowing on under the cars.
Right.
Don't want to put it back in the emergency pile.
Thank you so much. I'll leave just a little bit of remnants behind for these future archaeologists to find.